Hi, this is Kate from MinuteEarth. 10,000 years ago, we humans came up with a revolutionary new idea for how to feed ourselves. Agriculture. Plow land, plant a crop, water, fertilize, harvest, and repeat each year. And today, we're pretty much still doing the same thing as 10,000 years ago. Thanks to the Industrial Revolution, we are producing much larger quantities of food than we used to. But we are also putting far more resources into producing food than we used to. As a result, water levels in the world's largest aquifers are falling faster than they're being replenished. Our underground supply of phosphorus, a nutrient critical to plant photosynthesis, will be exhausted in a few hundred years. And we're using up the very ground itself, since soil blows and washes off of our fields 50 times faster than it forms. We can extend the life of these inputs with resource-saving techniques like precision farming and technologies like gene editing. But it's likely that no amount of retrofitting our 10,000-year approach to farming will make it work for billions of people for the next 10,000 years. So what are future humans going to do about dinner? One possibility is to switch to a food-making system where resources get recycled rather than depleted. Radical as it sounds, this kind of system already exists all around us, in nature, where sunlight is the only major energy input, and ecosystems comprised of many different coexisting plants and critters cycle nutrients and water within the system, or use resources at a rate equivalent to how much is coming in. We have started taking some cues from natural ecosystems, like interspersing crops with trees to encourage a healthy habitat for pollinators and pest controllers, and by changing the crops themselves. For example, we've begun to develop perennial forms of wheat, rice, and other grains that can live through many harvests, unlike traditional grains, which we have to plow and replant every year. The idea is to eventually grow the new grains alongside a variety of other long-lived plants in self-sustaining ecosystems that keep hold of soil, water, and nutrients. If we could manage to do this for all of our food, it would be qualitatively different from any other way humans have grown food on a large scale. Not quite hunting and gathering, not plant, harvest, repeat, but a sort of futuristic blend between the two.
Hey there, I'm Alex. I'm here visiting the Land Institute, the sponsor of this video. They're creating a new form of agriculture. It mimics natural ecosystems in order to help feed the world's population with fewer environmental impacts. Here at the Land Institute, plant breeders and ecologists are developing perennial grains, legumes, and oilseeds, like these behind me. The goal is to grow them in ecologically functional and diverse mixtures called polycultures. To learn more about how the Land Institute's perennial polycultures could help revolutionize agriculture, or to support their work, visit landinstitute.org.